for Mr. Kenny Dixon Jr.
I wish I was making that much. I shall give you some. Hey, look here, I'm just gonna play a couple of records. I ain't come down here to get down, but you know, this is Detroit. This is my home. You dig what I'm saying, baby? I'm gonna play a couple records for you. Chill out for a minute. Y'all do y'all thing. I'm love Detroit. Love it, baby.
It stands out on the highway like a creature from another time. It's quite for their mothers as they ride. No one knows how they would survive, and we've almost lost Detroit this time. How would we ever get over losing house from Detroit? It takes seconds from annihilation, and we almost lost Detroit.
Hey, y'all gonna have to excuse me, but I'm playing that again. You understand? You gonna have to excuse me right now. Hey, we got somebody from the Last Poets up here. Up in here, you understand what I'm saying? We got so many lovely, so many beautiful colors out here tonight. This looks so good. You know, everybody up here driving through Detroit, that's so wonderful. I drive in it, you understand? Every day. I'm gonna start this over. I'm doing my thing. What's up, Cax?
It stands out on the highway like a creature from another time. It inspires the baby's questions.
What's that?
For their mothers as they ride. But no one stopped to think about the babies or how they would survive. We've almost lost Detroit this time. How would we ever get over losing our minds? Just 30 miles from Detroit stands a giant power station. It ticks each night as the city sleeps, seconds from annihilation. But no one stopped to think about the people, how they would survive.
And we almost lost Detroit.
this time. How would we ever get over losing our mind? The sheriff of Monroe County had a sure enough disasters on his mind. And what would Karen Silkwood say to you if she was still alive? That when it comes to people's safety, money wins out every time. Detroit, that time, almost lost Detroit, that time, and how will we ever get over, we're gonna lose somewhere, one time.
This out, Detroit. We got Umar Ben Hassan from the Last Poets up here tonight. You dig what I'm saying? You know, I'm at home right now. And everybody go, they leave, they traveling somewhere. Guess where I'm going, baby? I'm going home. Right from here. You dig? You dig what I'm saying? Come on down here, baby. Mr. Umar Ben Hassan.
Can y'all hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Now you can hear me? Can you hear this mic? Can you hear the mic? Well, let me hear you say something. All right, I'm just up here to, I guess, be a fool. Phil, what's up? But this poem is dedicated to all the personal people out there in the audience. You can turn the music up a little bit more, man. A little bit more. It goes like this. Time in. Time in. Time in becomes time out. Group anxieties become personal doubt. Expressing ourselves as dot dots and dashes. pure cocaine and false eyelashes. Living, 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 living inside words that seem to lie. Living inside excuses that pass us by. Living inside loneliness becomes a high. Living is mixed up with learning to die. A daily question of going insane while tormenting one another, trying to ease the strain. Dreaming, dreaming of tomorrows. We'd like to know, repressing our thoughts, but wanting to grow. Repressing our thoughts, but wanting to grow. Turned into robots through the power of suggestion. We seek an answer and become the question. We're born, we're baptized, advertised, and posthumously mentioned. Turned into robots through the power of suggestion. We seek an answer and become the question. Afraid we might die before we live. Rest with life within a faith to give. We want to be ambulance, glamorous, and larger than life. Our cheap illusions become high-priced strife. Losing ourselves and times of despair become subject figures of unusual flair. We rush towards the beginning that might be the end. We sit in the darkness and try to pretend. Pointing fingers while our insides bleed. Committing suicide to fulfill a need. Highly intelligent in a very low way. We speak of resisting, but have nothing to say. We touch religion. We touch religion and make it seem like hell. But then we touch unholy dreams and wish them well. Faith is replaced with apathy and grief. Indifference is made acceptable and then a belief. Our left eyes are glitter while our right are blind. We submit to this madness and hope it is kind. Distraught women seeking compassion by turning tricks in high Roman fashion, finding love at the expense of losing their cool, looking for happiness but finding a fool. Their moments of trust become deceitful charms. One night stands in strangers' arms, carousing with disaster in very high places while cutting off noses to spite their faces. While the men play games of power and glory, catch a glimpse of an old war story outside themselves, inside their heads, count secret discussions on waterbeds. Men without neither rhyme nor reason, lost in the depths of mental treason, abstract victims of the American dream, victims of a disguise, a well-planned scheme, victims of a subtle but dangerous game. Rugged individualism with a psychotic name. We consume, we express the normal, and we absorb the extreme. We make war a reality and call peace a dream. American contradiction in black and white. We illuminate contradiction and call it the light. America provides you with fortune and fame while stealing your soul for its own acclaim. With the English language at its command, it perpetuates illusion throughout the land. Running big game in tiny print. Before you've got it, it's already spent. Making sacrificial lambs of the middle class. Indulging in rhetoric with his head up. It lulls you to sleep with the 6 o'clock news. It lulls you to sleep with the 6 o'clock news, and then wakes you up and spoon feeds you blues. But from the darkness of ourselves, we can find a brighter day. Understanding and truth must show the way. To understand that every man's color will not be as hard. To go inside yourselves, and where it must start. To learn to be considerate, to learn to be humane. To learn to use power and not become vain. To understand you can be strong and not be cruel. You can be outspoken and not be rude. To revile the tyrant, to protect the weak. To ensure the innocent, the right to be meek. To look on the sea and understand this motion. To understand tenderness and give it devotion. To understand courtesy and to make it a pact. To understand what love is and make it a fact. Because we all must struggle, we all must try. Because somewhere in the future, we all must die. But to leave a legacy which will long unfurl, that ours too was a struggle for a better world. How many of you knew about The Last Poets? Can I get this mic up a little bit here? Can I get this mic up a little bit? Please. Can I get my... We're going to do a poem now called Niggas Are Scared of Revolution. And that's to all you niggas in the crowd. Because evidently, all y'all seem to be niggas in Detroit this weekend. Give Moody Man Kenny Dixon a nice hand for sharing the stage with me. Moody Man! And give Carl Craig and Kelly Marvin for putting all this together. Give them a nice hand. And give the city of Detroit for still being here to have all this going on. Niggas! Niggas are scared of revolution, but niggas shouldn't be scared of revolution, because revolution is nothing but change, and all niggas do is change. Niggas coming from work and changing the pimp clothes, they hit the streets and make some quick change. Niggas change their hair from black to red to blonde, from perm to dread to curls, from black to red to blonde, and hope like hell the looks will change. Niggas kill other niggas when they don't receive a next change. Niggas change, change, change. You and niggas say things are changing, things are changing, yeah, things are changing. Nigga things into black nigga things. Black nigga things that go through all kinds of changes. The change in the day that makes them mad rage. Black power, black power. And the change that comes over the night as they shy and moan. Ooh, white lies. Ooh, white lies. Niggas always gone through bullshit change. But when it comes for real change, niggas are scared of revolution. Niggas are actors. Ooh, niggas are actors. Niggas act like they're in a hurry to catch the first act of the great white hope. Niggas try to act like Malcolm did, but when the white man doesn't react towards them like he did Malcolm, niggas want to act cowardly. Niggas act so cool and slick, causing white people to say, what makes those niggas act like that? Niggas act like you ain't never seen nobody act before, but when it comes to acting out for revolutionary causes, niggas reply, I can't dig them actions. Niggas are scared of revolution. Niggas are very untogether people. Niggas talk about getting high and riding out of hell. Niggas should get high and ride to hell. Niggas talk about pimping. Pimping what? Pimping yours, pimping mine. Just to be pimping is a hell of a line. Niggas are very untogether people. Niggas talk about the mind. Talk about, I got that bitch's mind uptight. Niggas don't know a damn thing about the mind, or they'd be right. Niggas are scared of revolution. Niggas fuck. Niggas fuck. Niggas fuck, fuck, fuck. Niggas love the word fuck. They think they're so fucking cute. They fuck you around. The first thing they say when they're mad is fuck it. You play a little too much with them. They say fuck you. When it's time to TCB, niggas are somewhere fucking. Try to be nice to them. They fuck over you. Niggas don't realize what they're doing. All this fucking, they getting fucked around. But when they do realize, it's too late. So all niggas do is just get fucked. Niggas talk about fucking, fucking that, fucking this, fucking yours, fucking nonsense, not knowing what they fucking for. Ain't fucking for love and appreciation, just fucking to be fucking. Niggas fuck white thighs, black thighs, brown thighs, yellow thighs. Niggas fuck Eagles, 21 outer thighs. Niggas fuck Sally, Lyndon, Sue. And if you don't watch out, niggas will fuck you. Niggas will fuck, fuck, if it could be fuck. But when it comes to fucking for revolutionary causes, niggas say, fuck revolution. Niggas are players, woo! Niggas are players. Niggas play football, basketball, and baseball while a white man is cutting off their balls. When a nigga's playing tight enough to play with some black thighs, niggas play with white thighs to see if they left to play left. And when they know white thighs to play with, niggas play with themselves. Niggas will tell you, maybe they should be liberated, but when you say let's go take our liberation, niggas reply, oh, we're just playing. Niggas are playing with revolution and losing. Niggas are scared of revolution. Niggas do a lot of shooting. Niggas do a lot of shooting. Niggas shoot out the mouth. Niggas shoot pool. Niggas cut around the corner and shoot down the street. Niggas shoot crap, CeeLo. Niggas shoot dope into the arms. Niggas shoot sharp glances at white women. Niggas shoot guns and rifles on New Year's Eve. A nigga that is coming in for white police will do more shooting at them. Where are niggas when the revolution needs some shots? Yeah, you know, niggas are somewhere shooting the shit. Niggas are scared of revolution. Niggas
niggas are lovers. Oh, niggas are lovers. Niggas love to cross table, make love to Marilyn Monroe. Niggas love to shoot cars and fuck other natives. Niggas love to hit a long range and yell, hi-ho, silver! Niggas love commercials. Niggas love commercials. Oh, how niggas love commercials. You can take niggas out of the country, but you can't take the country out of niggas. Niggas are lovers. Niggas are lovers. Niggas love to hear Malcolm rap. Niggas love to hear Malcolm rap, but they didn't love Malcolm. Niggas love everything but themselves. Niggas love everything but themselves. Niggas love everything but themselves. But I'm a lover too, yeah, I'm a lover too. I love niggas because niggas are me. And I should only love that which is part of me. Love to see niggas go through changes. Love to see niggas act. Love to see niggas shoot them shots and make them plays. But there's one thing about niggas I do not love. Niggas are scared of revolution. Moody Man, thank you everybody, have a nice time. Thank you, Moody Man.
Hey, hold on, hold on. Hold on. We got to get down here. We in Detroit. What's up, Umar? What's up, Last Poets? What's up, huh? Y'all don't understand that, but I see you. I see you, Detroit. I know where you're at up in here. I don't care what you're wearing or what shade you are. I know where you're at. I know. What's happening, Detroit? It's a lovely day. I was hoping it rained, because I love it when it's good and wet and soft. I ain't going to lie to you. Little Curtis Mayfield for you right now. We're going to get on down.
Granted, love you see, you made the love tender.
Adrian. I see you, baby, looking good. Yes, you are. Sunroof top, digging the scene with a gangster lean. Ooh.
darling. Girl, I'm giving you all my love. See, anytime is the right time, baby. Come on and take my heart. It's all yours if you want it, baby. My heart is tearing all apart. I say, ooh,
you can have it,
yeah. If you want it,
if you want it,
come and get it, baby. But if you want it,
you can have it.
I'll come and get it, girl, yeah.
If you want it,
yeah, yeah. See, darling, there's no time for wasting, baby. Come on, please, make up your mind. Good loving is so pleasing, baby. Girl, I'm giving you all my time. You can have it if you want it. Just come and get it, and baby, it's yours, yeah. I've got to give it if you want it. I know that you're gonna love it. Just come on, girl.
I knew you would like it. Oh, baby, you got me saying something like, ooh,
ooh, shibby-doo, stiddin-diddy-doo, stiddy-da-da-da. Listen now. One night while I was sleeping, baby, had a dream of you and I. Found myself asking you, baby, take my hand and be my wife. There's no time for wasting, baby, because we've gone all through those moves. Cause I'm offering satisfaction, darling. Girl, I'm giving you all my love.
You can have it,
yeah, if you want it.
What's up, Detroit? I'm just up here doing my thing. What's happening, Kurt? I see you. I see you. Kex and Red. Ahmed. What's up, baby? What's happening? Theo Parrish. What's happening, bro? Angela Clark. Malik. Chris B. Ski Dog Rock. What's happening, baby? Dean, don't think I see you. What's up, Michelle? Are y'all right? What's up, Detroit? Oh, baby, it feels so good. What's up, Wyoming? What's up, Schoolcraft? What's up, 7 Mile? I'm all up through that. Yeah. I'm just doing my thing. Couple more records. Bone, I don't see you.
Thank you. morning, people. Take a look out your window. Our world is
check one, two. I got a couple more minutes up here, and I'm going to get on up out of here. I'm just doing my thing, just playing a few records. You know, I ain't doing nothing special. We got the Roots coming up, Slum Village. Right up here in Detroit, baby. You understand? What's up, 7 Mile? What's up, Gus? What's up, East Side? What's up, West Side? What's happening, Detroit? I love you, baby. I really do.
Thank you. Okay, what's up? Shut up. All right, hey, everybody, make some noise for Mr. Kenny Dixon Jr. Yeah! Also, Umar Bin Hassan for the poetry, y'all. Show some love. Show some love. Hi, my name is Reggie Reg from FM 98 WJLB. We're going to take a pause for the calls, and then we're going to return with Slum Village. Yeah! Gary Chandler, Mos Def. And my boys, The Roots. Shout out to my man K-Stone in the house on the west side. Yeah! All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back, y'all. All my cousins in the house. What up?
I'm gonna come back later on and check out everybody else. You know, I'm a fan first. You know, I'm gonna be out there with y'all. I wanna enjoy myself too. Yeah. This was a short notice thing, but I came on down, do my thing, going home.